Learn from my mistakes as I share four reasons why all my seedlings died. Hi everybody, welcome to Living Traditions Homestead. My name is Sarah and I really want an opportunity to share with you why all of my seedlings last spring died. It was all my fault, and I want to share with you so that you can learn from my mistakes and hopefully I can learn from my own mistakes and not have that happen again this spring. So last year was our first year gardening here in the Missouri Ozarks. I planted a lot of seeds inside. I didn't buy one single transplant that went into our garden. We started everything. And really, that is the most cost-effective thing to do, especially when you're homesteading. If you are producing a great quantity of your own food, it really is most cost effective to start from seed. But if you start all your seeds and then they all die, then where are you? You've completely failed. Last year I started strong and I was going to plant 40 each of broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage, and Brussels sprouts. And I started them all and it ended up that they all died. Now, in hindsight and after researching what I did wrong, I figured out that there are four main things that I did wrong, and I want to share with you those things. The first thing that I did wrong last year when I was starting seeds and working with my seedlings is I didn't fertilize them. Now, on our homestead, the fertilizers that we use are all natural. We use fish emulsion, liquid seaweed, compost tea, and a rabbit manure tea. And with seedlings, what I've found out is that when their first set of true leaves appear and they're mature, you need to start fertilizing your seedlings with a 50% strength of whatever fertilizer or natural fertilizer you will be using. That will give them the nutrients that they need to continue growing and thriving and becoming strong. When you're first sprouting your seeds, just like a chick coming out of the egg, when a chick hatches from an egg, the yolk provides all of the nutrients that they need to survive for the first 3 to 5 days. Similarly, a seed inside that seed provides all the nutrients and strength that they need to sprout and form their first two leaves, which are not true leaves. They're just the first leaves of that plant. After that, when they grow their next set of leaves, which are called the true leaves, they need nutrients in order to be healthy. So that is the first thing that I did wrong last year. I didn't fertilize them. The second thing that I did wrong last year is that I allowed the plants to get too big before I transplanted them into something. And to be honest with you, I started them in kind of the medium-sized soil blocks last year, and that was fantastic until they got too big. What I should have done was transplanted them from the state that they were in there into the next size bigger soil block. And if you're planting in seed plugs or little seed trays, once they get to a certain size, in order to continue their growth and in order for them to continue maturing, you need to transplant them into a larger pot if they're not ready to go into the garden. There are several options for you. Now, big box stores and the nurseries all have different size options for you to transplant into. You're normally going to be starting out your seeds in a little plug tray, and you can gently lift those out of there and transplant them into a 2-inch pot like this. And if they grow well in here and then it's time for you to put them right into the garden, then you can just transplant them out of here and into the garden. But if you're starting your seeds further and further away from the time that they need to be planted into the garden, this may end up being a several step process. You may need to go from your plug tray into the 2-inch pot, into a 3-inch pot, and maybe even into a 4-inch pot. And that all depends on how quickly you are starting all of your seeds in the winter and how much time you have before you can put them into the garden. I didn't do that, and because I didn't, I stunted their growth, and they never really got very big. After 8 or 10 weeks, they were still pretty small, and that was really to the detriment of my success. So how do you know when it's time to transplant your little seedlings from one container to the next? Well, initially, when you first have a seedling growing in a little plug tray or whatever, once your set of first true leaves become mature, that's your first opportunity to transplant from one location to another location. When you have your seedlings growing in a plug. Now, this obviously isn't a plug, but I'm going to use this for demonstration purposes. If you have your seedling growing out of here, you should be able to either gently pull your plant out with the soil attached to it, or maybe even turn it upside down like this and give it a little pat and have it come out in your hand like this. And if you can see roots on the outside layer of the soil, it's time to transplant them either into a bigger pot or into the garden, whichever makes most sense for your situation, okay? So that's how you can determine if it's time and when it's time to transplant your seedlings from one pot to another. The third reason why all of my seedlings died last year is because I completely failed to harden them off. The process of hardening off your seedlings means to expose them gradually and more gradually to the sun, to wind, fluctuating temperatures, and not being watered as often. If you don't harden them off properly, your plants can get very stressed out. If you just put them outside, from being inside, straight outside to being there all of the time, they can die. And when you are hardening them off properly, you will take 7 to 10 days from the time that before you want to plant them in the garden, and you will start bringing them outside in kind of a sheltered place that they can get kind of part sun, part shade, where it's not going to be super windy, and on a mild day that's not going to be super hot or super cold. And you will begin increasing the amount of hours that those plants stay outside until it's the day that they can be planted in the garden. I would suggest starting having them outside for 2 to 3 hours the first day, and then increasing that gradually by an hour or two until you reach 7 to 10 days, and then you can put them in the ground. So that is the third reason why all of my seedlings died. I didn't harden them off. The fourth reason, and the last reason, why all of my seedlings died last year is because I got excited and I couldn't wait any longer, and I planted them in the garden too early and they all froze. Every location has a expected last frost date. The date that's commonly recognized as the last possible date for you to get frost. Now, it's an estimation. You may have your last date of frost 2 weeks earlier, or you may have your last date of frost 2 weeks later. Plants are generally categorized by whether they can be planted just after the expected last day of frost, or if you can plant ahead of time. Now, I'm talking specifically about what happened to me, and I was trying to plant broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage, Brussels sprouts, and those things can generally be planted about a month before the last date of frost because they're a little bit frost hardy. And I actually also looked on a university website which told me that I could go as early as 6 weeks before the last date of frost and put my plants in, those cold hardy plants. But the combination of the fact that I didn't fertilize, I didn't transplant, I didn't harden off, and then I put them in the ground on the early side, they were not healthy. They were very weak. They were very small. And then there was a freeze. And because of all of those things, they died. So my recommendation as far as when you should put your plants in the ground is maybe even wait a week or two after everything you're reading, just to be safe that all of your hard work, all of the expense, all of the time, all of your effort will actually turn out positive and not negative. Because I'll tell you, after I lost all of those plants, I started 50, but expected to plant 40 of each of those. I was totally devastated. I was completely deflated, and I really didn't want to do it all over again. And to be honest with you, we just didn't. I kind of put some seeds in the ground, and I just was so discouraged that I didn't even weed them. I barely watered them, and we had a terrible experience with them last year, but it was all my fault. And so I wanted to learn from those experiences so that I can have a positive result this year and have all of those fresh veggies available for me and my family this year. So as I was thinking through all of that, and as I was researching and learning myself, I thought, you know what, I need to share this information because it's important, and I want all of you to succeed in your growing experiences so that you can gain the confidence to continue doing it. I want to share something with you. I love to garden, and I have loved to garden for a really long time. I think I have a green thumb, and a lot of other people have said that they think I have a green thumb. But to be honest with you, I really think that successful gardening is about 80% learned and only 20% a natural gift or intuition or whatever you would call it. You know, you can learn the knowledge and develop and learn the skills to garden. I believe that truly, and I hope that gives you confidence that you can learn how to successfully garden and provide for your family. You guys, I am so glad that you stopped by the homestead today to figure out how I killed all of my seedlings last year. I'm definitely going to learn from that experience, and I really hope that you learn from my experiences. If you enjoyed my video today, I would sure appreciate it if you would make sure to subscribe to our channel and comment and share this video. Until next time, you guys, thanks so much for stopping by the homestead. Take care and God bless.